It's in my role now to sum up the lessons learned at this conference, and I took a lot of notes, and to link all this into the role of financial advisors and intermediaries in private retirement planning in the future. I mean, what is sure is that the existing inequalities in terms of social protection will enhance by future demographic change. And I think that still a vast majority of European citizens is not aware about the problems they will face on their personal retirement situation. In my home country, I'm from Austria, the national security last year in 2014 launched a so-called Pensionskonto. Maybe you have read in the newspaper about it. It is an internet platform. It is accessible for everybody who is state insured. And once you are logged in, you see how much public pension you have accumulated so far on a daily basis. So this is the typical fintech, but not by a private company. It's run by our social security office. And one might assume that to know about your daily basis of public pension is a very important information. So, what is the experience so far in Austria? Millions of people received a personal letter from the National Security Office, and only a few thousand per year use the online service. The consumers, the people who have received these letters, are at a total loss with the information. Whenever we, the intermediaries, visit the client, they show us the letters from their social security scheme, and then they ask us what to do with them. And then we help them, for example, to access their online pension account for the first time, and then we guide them into understanding of the comprehensive data and information so that they can realize what is it all about. And this is the experience with a wonderful technical platform. What I think we can also sum up is that a holistic approach to pension reforms, we have heard about first, second, and third pillar, it means that European citizens cannot solely rely on public pension anymore in the future. So this is so far accepted. In order to shift from what age called impressively a decent to a dignified economic status in retirement, the European citizens will need their own savings. And of course, such investments will have to deliver good performance. And in times of low interest rates, this means taking calculated risks on the capital markets. So these risks constantly need to be monitored. They need to be assessed with the clients. They need to be reallocated on a constant, best on a at least annual basis. As we have learned, 6 months on the capital markets are a universe. So who shall do it with the client? Standardized pension concepts with guaranteed assets, to my opinion, are no solution for a long-term retirement savings. This, by the way, has once again been demonstrated by the Czech pension reform recently in 2013. The Czech state issued a standardized and reputedly safe pension product. It was sold via the internet. Once again, it's a fintech by the Czech state. And the experience so far was overwhelmingly negative, such as there is a guarantee of no loss, a black zero, which inhibits any potential for a higher yield. There is a low cap on charges and fees, which inhibits the sales function, which led to a very low, to a limited penetration of the product after 2 years in the Czech population. Nearly nobody bought this product. And even a standardized and simple product now turns out it was contracted not efficiently, it was contracted in the wrong way. The advice is still crucial. Honestly, we as intermediaries fully agree with the Commission, with the EIOPA, and also with the panelists and keynotes, because that the intent to increase the amount of savings that European citizens accumulate for retirement is a good objective. And we need to state, however, it is pivotal to strictly maintain first a level playing field with all the existing regulation we have, with MiFID II, IDD, PRIIPs, UCITS, anti-money laundering, data protection, etc., etc. And if this the internet platform can confirm and provide, and it is properly licensed as broker, agent, and advisor, we will be perfectly fine with it. And the second we have to state is that please let us avoid experimenting with features proven already unsuitable in previous experiences. We don't need to undergo these experiences a second time. We as IFAs will also be happy to endorse any efforts to enable an increased number of consumers maintain their finances online, but it has to be taken into account that the personal retirement is maybe one of the most important decisions in the financial life of any European citizen. There is no second chance if you are 65 and you have no pension. So custom education to rely on informed and well-trained financial literate citizens, I think this is a very laudable effort. It is doomed to failure in the short term. And even enhancing long-term financial education via public schools, for example, this will not help the majority of citizens who have already finished school and they need to take a well-informed decision for their financial future now. I think, therefore, regulation should be strictly distribution neutral and it should not be tailored in favor to any channel. Regarding the robo-advice, well, generally computers are very good at doing the things we find hard and they struggle to manage the things we find most easy. Most activities that dominate our business, the advisory sector, are classic examples of that kind of activities. And you may forgive me, I'm not only trained as a financial advisor, but as a therapist, as a psychotherapist, that computers will never carry out sufficiently. Yeah? To carefully listen to a client, fine, show me the computer program which can do it. To make a client aware of risks, of chances, to drink a cup of coffee with the client together, yeah, and talking about his future or her future plans. I think, therefore, skilled advice and ongoing maintenance is crucial, and it's now crucial, and it will be even more crucial in the future. And that is the reason, and by, to my opinion, to the foreseeable future, the majority and the vast majority of retirement products will be distributed via a non-digital channel, which does not mean that we should neglect the oncoming strength, and I agree with what has been said, the quick development of technical facilities, and to bear in mind how we can integrate these technical facilities into our daily business. I think this should also be a wake-up call for us as intermediaries to make more transparent to the client what is our service, and it is definitely a service worth of money and not for free, which was a big mistake we did in the past, to say that we have the free advice, because something which is free in a commercial world is worth nothing. I hope you enjoyed so far this year's FESIF conference. I say thank you to our keynote speakers and panelists for taking the time to be with us today and share their insights and expertise. I thank all of our sponsors for supporting FESIF and the work we do so far for the financial and financial advisory industry. And I congratulate my team at FESIF for superbly organizing this year's conference.